कैन वी
टेम्पल।
स्टार्ट? हाँ
यस
हाँ बोलिए, कुछ और बोलने वाले थे कोई?
सर, टेम्परेचर के साथ विस्कोसिटी डिक्रीज होती है या इंक्रीज होती है?
इन केस ऑफ लिक्विड इट बेंड डाउन, यू कैन सी दिस पर्टिकुलर फिगर हियर, सो आई कैन एक्सप्लेन हियर एक्चुअली. सो वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एक्चुअली एक्सप्लेन दैट इफेक्ट ऑफ विस्कोसिटी ऑन टेम्परेचर एंड वेरियस फ्लूइड विद देयर विस्कोसिटी डेटा. सो व्हाट यू हैव हियर, दिस इज द एब्सोल्यूट विस्कोसिटी हियर ऑन वाई एक्सिस. एक्स एक्सिस यू हैव द टेम्परेचर हियर. सो यू सी द लिक्विड्स हियर. सो दिस दिस the top portion here, if you will see from here, the top two till this gasoline just your petrol actually. So all the cases, your viscosity, you can say that this one castor oil, glycerol, engine oils, various engine oils are there. Then crude oil for this, let's say, petroleum part here. Then you have aniline, you have mercury, you have kerosene. So all these cases, you see viscosity is decreasing with respect to time, because in that case, what happens here, that first thing, that as you will heat them up, all fluid actually expands. So expands mean their mean free path blows up or goes up, and ultimately molecules become free. So means they cannot sustain more shear actually. So they are have more flowing type of characteristic actually. Therefore, their viscosity is decreasing. At the same time, gases, always molecules are too much far away. So if you will heat them up, they are already very much far away apart. So if you will heat them up more and more, so the randomness of the particle would become, and once you have too much the randomness of the particle, so it's very impossible to other thing to move in that particular area. Just like this much confined area, you have some area, you have some particle, and that kinetic energy is too much high that something else cannot cross their path. So in that case, it's very tough to disturb such type of the molecule, the system there. So in case of gases, viscosity increases here. So you see that last bottom lines here, the four, you have helium gas here, you have carbon dioxide, you have air, you have hydrogen. So in this case, this viscosity is increasing with respect to temperature, but you see the value is not changing very tremendously high something here. You see all of them here till here, this the hydrogen, the order is 10 to the power minus 5. Only thing it is changing in terms of 1, 2, 3, 1 into 10 to the power minus 5, 2 into. So the variation is not much high, but it's increasing only. And after that, you see here, once you have increased the sufficient the randomness here, you see after 80 here, the nothing is getting changed. You see almost constant, right? So everything has some the limitations. Once you have reached to a particular value, the threshold value, after that nothing changed. So that is the, you can say all these gases threshold value of temperature is close to 80, or in some case, in this case you have, in case of hydrogen you have 100 only. You see in case of the mercury graph here, this one, the mercury graph viscosity initially decrease, after that you say the no change here, because the mercury, the boiling point is excessively high. And in that case, the molecules are not that much free. The cohesive energy of the molecules is too much high, so not much effect on viscosity. These are some common fluid which generally being used actually. So in mechanical engineering branch, you deal with engine oils actually. So there are various grades of the engine oil. So they're based on their the lubrication property here. So you have this SAE 30, 10, and 50. Mercury we use in our chemical engineering preparation, mostly we use in manometers and thermometers. So we need some viscosity parameters just to calculate some viscous means the losses here. A common fluid, ethanol, so it's just giving the example only. So it can be used for transport or not. It's a common fluid only. Most of the time, all engineers, be it the civil engineer, be it chemical engineer, be it mechanical engineer, everybody deals with flowing of water actually. So water is most commonly used, so you should know at least the property of water. So viscosity of water at 20 degrees C is from here. Is 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg per meter per second. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. So that's here for water. And let's say the water at 100 degrees Celsius, it means water has converted to vapor. And then this viscosity is 1 into 10 to the power minus 5, just same of air actually, right? Air ka bhi velocity viscosity we will see here at 20 degree C from here, this would be somewhere here because this is the order of 10 to the power minus 5 only. So you see the air is again 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5. And so air and water, these two property at least you should know it. So because once you will use in many calculations, so some of the data, this is common fluid. You should know it actually. Okay. Now, how to measure the viscosity actually? So this is just a practical here that how to measure the viscosity part. So what you have here, you have these two cylinders here. One is this outer cylinder, is just a cylindrical container actually. So you have one is the inner cylinder and one is the outer cylinder. Just like have you seen the piston of your bike or any engine so far? Or maybe your mixer grinder actually. So the mixer grinder, you have an outer ball, inside of that you have the rotor, right? Have you seen that?
Yes,
Yes.
sir. Yes.
Huh. So it's the same type of thing in case of the mixer, that blade case, you have just a cylinder there also. So you have two cylinders, one is the outer cylinder, one is the inner cylinder. So just like that, you have this one. So this is your the cylinder. So one, and then the one more, just like you can put a pan here. So that is the inner cylinder and the outer cylinder. And in between of that, you are filling the your fluid only. So you have here this the pink mark one is the fluid here. This is the inner cylinder which you want to the rotate at some means velocity here by putting some force. Outer cylinder is the stationary here. So stationary means here you will have no slip condition, means velocity of the fluid is zero because the outer cylinder is the stationary. Inner cylinder, you are moving at some RPM. So this RPM can be calculated by your speedometer or tachometer. Tachometer gives the RPM, I mean the RPM. So you can measure, or you can just also put a pointer there by putting a red mark or white mark. After that, you can visually note from time taken for a particular number of the rotations, right? So that you can also calculate that manually, or you have gauges also. So you will move this particular cylinder at some particular RPM. So RPM, what will give that? If you have the angular velocity, you can calculate the linear velocity. Yes or no? You can calculate
Yes,
B
sir.
equal to R, B equal to R omega, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes or
Yes,
no?
sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
Yeah,
sir. Yes, sir.
you can calculate that. So, and once you have calculated velocity, then you can have a velocity gradient because the yesterday we have calculated velocity gradient, that dv upon dy. So dy is practically this the distance here, distance between the two cylinders, that is your dy. And velocity here, the highest velocity v is r omega here. Here the velocity here the zero. The total change in the velocity is r omega minus zero, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so at the shaft, you have the velocity r omega. At the outer cylinder, velocity is zero because the no slip condition. The gap is just L. So velocity gradient would be the delta V upon delta L only or delta Y. So delta V is R omega here. And then divided by L, that is velocity, the gradient. Now you want to calculate the shear stress. What we have taught in the last class, the shear stress is tau mu du upon dy, right?
Yes, sir.
That
Yes,
is the
sir.
shear stress formula. So shear stress multiplied by area would give you the shear force,
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
right? So that's what this formula is that here. So this tau here, tau, they are calculating practically the torque. So you are providing torque to the rotator. So you will connect it to a wheel, and wheel, you will put a pulley there, you will put some weight there. So you are calculating torque in that way. How to calculate torque?
Force into perpendicular distance.
Yeah, so that's what you have here, this F into R. So force into perpendicular the distance, if you are the applying force at this outer boundary of the inner cylinder, so that is force multiplied by this R is the torque only. How the force is? Force is just shear stress into area. So shear stress is mu du upon dy. So I can note you on this paper here, because here this short actually. So shear stress is this mu d. I will show you, just give me 1 minute. And then force would be tau into A. So tau is just mu R omega divided by L, area is two pi R. Now you can see this. Can you see this one? That दिख रहा है कि उल्टा दिख रहा है? ठीक दिख रहा है?
यस सर
ठीक दिख रहा है,
तो
दिख
फर्स्ट, हाँ फर्स्ट इज टाउ, टाउ इक्वल टू म्यू डी यू अपॉन डी वाई. म्यू इज विस्कोसिटी, दिस इज द न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ द विस्कोसिटी ओनली, राइट? एट द प्लेस ऑफ डी वी डी यू, यू हैव जस्ट वेलोसिटी चेंज. सो वेलोसिटी एट द इनर सिलेंडर वाज आर आर ओमेगा, आउटर सिलेंडर वाज जीरो, सो द डेल्टा वुड बी आर आर ओमेगा ओनली, राइट? Distance between two cylinders was just L, so you got this first line. After that, you want to calculate force, so you multiply tau into area. Area means the area in contact of the fluid, so that is was is the circum means the is curved surface area. So what is the formula of curved surface area? 2 pi RL, right? The length of the cylinder and perimeter, right? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
हाँ, so that way
Yes,
you
sir.
get this particular the expression here, which is the given in this particular line here. Simple, the torque equal to force into R, and then finally you got mu 2 pi R cube omega L by L. These L will not cancel because one L is the length of the cylinder, which is capital L. A small L practically is your delta R only, the difference between two radii. Fine. So this is the way you have designed the viscometer, that means coaxial the cylinder viscometer you have in that particular part. Okay, this is the easiest way to measure the viscosity. Once viscosity is done, after that you have surface tension of the fluid, and surface tension is also most important part. If you are talking about the flow in very thin channel, thin channels means just like the refill of the pan, which that is thin channel here. If bellowed force also, pressure also, some fluid will go up due to capillary action, right? Wherever you have the diameter broad and broad, it doesn't matter. But wherever the diameter is smaller and the smaller, the surface tension forces play the important role here. So you just need it. And these are the important for many bodies just to survive. Just like you see here, this particular this you can name the this particular insect is here. And now you can say where is it actually, on what surface. So once it is putting a force, this you can see the surface change here. So this is creating a surface tension at this particular part here. You see that in the morning when you do the shaving of then you see that water droplets hold on your face only because of the surface tension, because you have just erased the things and then you have created a rough surface there, and surface tension becomes too much high, and that therefore water droplet sticks here because without oil and all this. Same thing here in this particular part of this, you can see that these fine drops, this is only because of the surface tension. So if the surface tension is very high, it will try to minimize the area in contact of the contacting fluid, and so that its energy should be minimized, right? That is the concept of the surface tension. And therefore, your things become spherical. More, less is surface tension, it will become flatter and flatter actually. So the surface tension, practically you define, how do you define the surface tension?
Force per unit length.
Yeah, force per unit length. So you add the apply a force here and divide by entire the length of the contact, that is the surface tension only. That's what you have here. So the dimension of that force upon force is just the Newton, and just divided by your length. So Newton per meter, right?
Yes, sir.
Now these are some actually the you mean the important concepts which would be helpful to us. So let's say this first figure here. So here in this case you have one molecule here. To have the surface tension, you should always have the two surfaces. Within same medium, you cannot have the surface tension. If you are talking about here, this cannot have any surface tension here. But once you will go to the free surface here you have air, here you have the mean water molecule, mean the let's say some for timing this fluid is water. So this would have a surface tension here. Because what does the surface? Surface try to make it here straight or flat. That is the easiest possible. See, the simple way, if you want to be at rest, you should be just like a flat. If you are bending, means you are not in free mode, right? In free mode, just like that only. So same thing in the free surface here, this is flat only. So these molecules are the stretching each other in such a way that they should become flat only. Now, once it will come in contact here, it will have the two surfaces, one is the outer one is the inner one, and it will create a surface tension force. Now, what will happen here? How does it play the role? It is by chance, let's say this molecule is coming here. It is coming with some energy. And if the energy of this particular molecules is more than the surface tension energy of this particular surface here, it will leave the surface. So surface tension also will try to hold it there. If it is surface tension is very high, these molecules cannot go out here. Or previously you might have mean that you mean study that only because of cohesive forces. So cohesive forces are here. So cohesive forces also give rise to the some component of the surface tension actually. Another thing here you have here, you might have created sometime your soap bubbles and all this in your 12th, you might have studied the soap bubbles. How much that need to done expand it, right? That's what be in your 12th, right? Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
Huh.
Yes, sir.
So you did that. So in that case, let's say you have this surface here in the second figure on the top left. So initially you were at this particular plane here. After that, you have applied a force and pull this interface to from here to here. So you have changed it by delta x, the magnitude. सो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट फोर्स फोर मीन वर्क व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ वर्क सो वर्क इज फोर्स इनटू डिस्टेंस राइट इज द वर्क
यस सर
सो दैट इज द सिंपल फॉर्मूला वर्क शिवम कैन यू म्यूट योर माइक So the force is, I mean, work is force into that distance. The distance here was the delta x. So that is the work done here. The force into distance. So F into delta x. So in this case, the delta x here. Now, how would you calculate the force? So how much would be the force here? So this you can calculate from your surface tension part here. So you know the surface tension. Surface tension is force per unit length. Fine. Yes or no?
Yes.
Force per unit is means the length here. So this is the definition of the the surface tension force per unit length. Why it is 2B here? Can you tell me?
Sir, because दो surfaces count होंगे एक आगे का एक पीछे का उस interface का इसलिए 2B.
No. Wait. So you have this one, right? This is the length on which this particular force is acting. Okay?
Yes. Sir.
Now you are talking about 2B. Now she is saying the two surfaces. Which are the two surfaces? Can you tell in the figure? Where are two surfaces? This one and this one, or this one or its back wala? Which one?
इंटरफेस के आगे और पीछे वाला
तो इंटरफेस तो दिस वन है दिस इज द इंटरफेस ओनली दिस इज वन इंटरफेस ओनली
तो दिस इज सोप बबल में भी हम दो सर्फेसेस काउंट करते हैं ना एक बाहर का एक अंदर वाला फिर इसमें 2 का फैक्टर आ जाता है
सो नाउ यू सोप बबल इज द डिफरेंट नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल दैट आल्सो जस्ट लाइक दिस Let's one. I could not find the ball. So in case of the soap bubble, what you have soap bubbles have the something like that. So inside of that also you have the air here. Outside of that also you have the air. So therefore you have two interfaces which are in contact with the air. That's why you are the doubling the area. Fine. Same thing here, you have something of this type of film here. So air is also here, air is also here. Therefore, you have here the 2B. Okay?
Yes, sir.
In case of this, you see this one here.
Yes, sir. 2B
you have this, this is the wire here, wire film here, right? So you have the air in this surface also, air on this side also. Both the sides you have air, here also, here also. So the contact area with respect to the interface is the double here. Suppose you don't have air in this side. This is a confined part here. This water is filled in some particular channel, just like your first tank here. In this case, the interface only one, the top surface only. So that this the length would be here. Just is this the cross section area here? This one air only. The perimeter here. Perimeter is just the outer circumference that is in contact of your solid material and your liquid. Okay. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Well, let's see this one here. You can see this one, this particular figure here. So you have, this is just a wire here, which you are talking in this particular part here. So here, this wire is being pulled from both the sides. One is here, one is here. Because surface tension, both the sides, you have the air here. So therefore, this has came the 2B concept here. So you should understand how these 2B are connected here. Fine. So but what the means we have also one more case here, huh? You can see from here. So this, you see that this one here, this is just air bubble here, air bubble, and you have just cut it here. So if you will cut it here, what will have here? So this is the circumference here. Outside of that also you have the air, inside of that also you have the air. Air bubble or a half air droplet. So both the, so you have two contacting the surfaces here, one in the inside, one in the outer side. Now the area of the outer one, inner one are generally considered same because this film is being considered is very, very thin in terms of microns. So therefore your R1, R2s are same. So to keep it expanded here, what you need to make to keep the bubble as a bubble, what do you need? You need some particular pressure inside the bubble, otherwise it will collapse. Yes or no? To blow the balloon, you need some air to be pushed inside. So if that pressure is low, it will collapse. The pressure is high, it will blow more and more and more, it will burst. Is that fine or not?
Yes, sir.
So in that case here, to keep the air bubble in its position, you need a pressure there to keep it, to sustain your surface tension forces here. So surface tension forces would be applied on your out in the this particular surface in contact. So you have that perimeter multiplied by the surface tension, that is the surface tension force. Inside of that, you also have a pressure to the sustain that surface tension force. So if you know the pressure, the difference between inside and outside of that particular bubble, so that is your delta P. Outside pressure is P1, inside pressure is P2. So that P2 minus P1 is called delta P, the pressure of inside and outside difference. Fine. Multiply by area. So area of cross section here is, in case of the cylinder, pi R square.
Right.
So that is the area. So total pressure force inside is the pressure into area is the this much. So once the diameter of the bubble is constant, so total pressure forces has to be balanced by the surface tension forces here. So that's what the, this is the formula in the, mean the bottom here. For droplet or air bubble here, you have 2 pi r in the circumference multiplied by sigma here. And then you have here pi r square delta p, and therefore you got the formula here, the pressure difference or delta p is 2 sigma by r. This is soap bubble, and this is for droplet. Droplet means which is filled with water, or air bubble. Air bubble ke case mein both the side you have air, so your surfaces are 1 or 2.
One.
Yeah, because two. Both the side medium is same. No, it's not. Okay. In case of the droplet or air bubble, the bubble be air ka hi hai. So air outside medium, inside mediums are same. They cannot have two actually in that case. In case of the droplet, a droplet means the entire thing is being filled with water. I mean that the entire KFT is filled of water only. So water means the entire is one medium. So you have just say outer surface. In case of air also, you have the air also here and here also. So you have both the way one surface only. Now think for soap bubble. This is what you have, the soap bubble here. So inside of soap bubble, what you have inside of soap bubble, you have a thin layer. Thin layer which is of soap only. Fine. Hello.
Yes, sir.
So inside of the soap bubble, you have the figure is that this type only here. The soap bubble case, you have a thin layer of the soap. And then you have the air, the pressure inside there to make it blow, and outside of that, in case of soap bubble, you are getting that this surface tension will act now on the two surfaces, one in the inner one, one in the outer one here, and then you will get the your the delta P would be that the 4 sigma by r. So you have to keep in mind, in case of soap bubble, your surfaces are two by seeing this figure here. In case of drop, you have entire thing is being filled by the same particular fluid here, so you have only outer surface. In case of bubble, you have two surfaces, so you can keep in that way, bubble and droplet. Fine, with that way, that will be clear to you. Okay, एयर बबल में बबल भी एयर का ही था. इट्स नॉट ए बबल ऑफ वाटर. सो इफ बबल ऑफ वाटर तो ये आपका सोप बबल टाइप का बन जाएगा. तो देयरफॉर यू गेट टू सरफेसेस. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एयर बबल में दिस जस्ट एयर ओनली. जस्ट लाइक एयर बबल कहाँ बनेगा बताइए. आप वाटर लेके वाटर में आप एयर को जो है डिस्पर्स कर दीजिए. That is the air bubble only. Yes or no?
Yes.
Give some answer. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Two is coming in case of soap bubble, not in case of air bubble. So once you will blow the air out in the water, so entire bubble is filled up of air only. So you have the surface only in contact with the fluid only, right? So you have only one surface there. In case of soap bubble you are making in air only. So you have a soap liquid, soap ke inside may be air hai, and outside is also air. So therefore you are getting two surfaces in case of soap bubble. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
So then you should know the surface tension of some common fluids. So surface tension of water is given at the 20 degree Celsius is this 0.073 Newton per meter actually. And glycerin is also used, but the data generally are given to you because nobody is supposed to buy her them. But at least you should know for water, because somebody would ask for water and air because these are commonly used fluids, so at least you should know these values actually. So water is 0.073, and how much is air? Air mein hi calculate kiya gaya, right? So it's calculated here. Air ka surface tension, that's why it's considering as zero actually. Based on the air also you have calculated. Okay, have the surface tension, you always have two. So air is the reference medium here actually. Okay. Now capillary effect. So if you want to see the capillary effect means how does it happen? Surface tension always try to make the surface flat, but it doesn't happen because once you will have your fluid in contact of just like this first figure here. Here this water is being filled in some, let's say a tube or some container here. So here you have the surface. Surface is just a circumference where you have in contact. Now in this case here, what you have, what will happen here? Why did the surface has been become this type of curvature here? Can you tell any idea here?
Surface tension ज्यादा है.
Oh. मिनिस्कस हियर यू कैन एक्चुअली डू सम क्लासिफिकेशन हियर एक्चुअली हियर. So based on the meniscus shape, if this type here, so it means this is this fluid is wetting the fluid actually, or in this case the cohesive forces of water molecules are not very high as compared to the adhesive forces between water and this particular contact in the surface here. Fine. So here cohesive forces are low. इन केस ऑफ द मर्करी हियर द कोहेसिव फोर्स बिटवीन द मर्करी मॉलिक्यूल्स इज एक्सेसिवली हाई एंड दे डोंट वांट टू इन कॉन्टेक्ट ऑफ द फ्लूइड सो दे वांट टू मिनिमाइज द एरिया एज मच एज पॉसिबल हियर सो इन दिस केस दे वांट टू दिस सिंक द सर्फेस हियर सो देयरफॉर दिस मॉलिक्यूल्स ट्राई टू पुल इट हियर Okay, so in that case, the adhesive forces is low at compared to the cohesive forces. So the meniscus has become of something like that, inverted actually curve here. Now we want to calculate that how much would be this force, and based on the surface tension, can be calculated how much would be the rise or fall by its own here. So you can see here one in this capillary here. So this is just a glass tube here. Glass tube is just a 4 mm diameter tube here. So you can see the meniscus here, this black one here. So as we have the meniscus is means the diameter of tube is bigger and bigger, and somehow you can the mean the actually balance this particular curvature. So that we will do in the next slide here. Here this one. So what you have here, this is water here, and you have just inserted a glass tube. So what you have here, one is this contacting surface here, because here you have the water here. So water, the admin, adhesive forces are high. So water will, this particular glass will take the water molecules out due to high adhesive forces. If you see the inside of the tube here, so the here this is the contact again, so the adhesive forces are high, so water molecules will go up, and so in this case the curvature is something like this. Now we have not done anything here. This water has gone itself by its own. So we want to calculate how much, how does it go? I mean, why it has gone actually? That's what we want to calculate. Same thing here in case of the mercury here, that here the adhesive forces on this contact are not high. So water, this the mercury molecules are trying to leave away from the surface as much as they can minimize the area with this contact of this particular contact. So what they did only thing, they have the shrink at this particular corner. So area has been the minimized as compared to this. Here the area has went up. Here, by tilting here, they have just minimized some area here due to this high cohesive energy of the molecules here. So due to that here, this particular meniscus, this particular water level has gone down here. This is called capillary depression here. In this case, this is called capillary rise here. So this you say capillary depression or capillary fall. Water case here, you can say the capillary rise here. Now, how to calculate it here? That how much would be rise or what? So this is your surface point. So surface tension always act in the tangential direction here. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Surface tension acts only in tangential direction. So this is the surface here. So tangent on this will go this side here. So this is your surface tension here, sigma. Now this much would add on, now this is in that, so if you want to calculate the surface tension component in vertical sides, so because if you say that the contact area is a contact angle here is phi, now this particular phi here is, can you say this is the surface tension angle or contact angle or not? How to measure the contact angle, do you know? So that you can see from this third figure here. So here this is the contact, here you have the water, and this is the surface of the water here. So this contact angle has to be calculated only inside. So you draw the line here, this is contact surface, you draw the line here. So you draw the line in this side here. So this is your contact angle. You draw the tangent only within the fluid. So if you draw the tangent within the fluid, it would be or something like that. So the this angle would become your contact angle. So you can extend this to this side. So both will become opposite angles. So therefore, this is also your contact angle same, because if you draw the line here, it would be something like that. Fine. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Ha. So now the surface tension is this. Now we want the how much and this act on entire the circumference. So if you multiply surface tension by the circumference is 2 pi r, so you will calculate the surface tension force now. So the surface tension force is this, 2 pi r into sigma. Now that is on this side. Now we want to say how much component of this would be on vertical side. So vertical side would be 2 pi r sigma into cos pi?
Yes.
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes or no? So that would be the vertical component of the surface tension. It means this, the surface tension force will try to pull the your fluid up. How much can it be pulled? The time it would balance by the weight of the fluid. So the weight of the fluid is this much only in this particular, means the particular the tube here. So this much height went up h. So this h multiplied by entire cross-section area is the volume of the cylinder. Multiplied by the density would become the mass of the water inside this particular height. Multiplied by g would be the weight which will try to pull down the fluid, right? Surface tension trying to pull it up. Body weight trying to pull it down. So both need to be balanced in the equilibrium condition, right? So therefore, you the balances here. So this h, you can write here in this way actually. I will show you that expression here. So in that case, you have body weight is first is pi r square is the area, multiplied by h would be your volume, multiplied by density would be the mass, multiplied by g would be the weight. So this is your body weight component. You are balancing by surface tension sigma into 2 pi into cos pi. So can you see this one, this expression, the second one? So you are calculating first is volume inside that particular height, that is pi r square h, right? Multiplied by rho is the mass, multiplied by g would become weight. That is your weight of the fluid inside the tube. It would be balanced by surface tension force, that is the sigma into 2 pi r into cos pi. Fine. So by balancing this, you are getting the expression for h here. So that is 2 sigma upon rho g r into cos pi. Now, can we control it? Can we control the height? Suppose we don't want height. We don't want this particular height here. We just want a flat surface. What can we do? Why do we need flat surface? Yesterday also we did a practical, right? There also we have to measure the height on this particular the manometer with the piezometric height, the fluid in Bernoulli practical, right? We did or not? So meniscus is always there, and we always take the height. The somebody can take the down meniscus, somebody can take the upper one, and it will always give you the confusion. Okay, where to measure the exact height? So to make it flat, what can you do here from the formula? How can you minimize the capillary rise from this formula? Can you give some thought on that?
Sir, theta is equal to
theta, right? Actually, yeah, theta equal to something, let's say cos 90 is the zero, right?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So 90 करने के लिए theta, हाँ, so theta somehow is not in our hand. Can you tell me why? Because once we say our tube is made up of glass, if tube is made up of glass, flowing fluid is water, theta is not in our hand because we have fixed both the things. We have fixed a contact, the surface, which is glass, We have fixed the fluid, so these two are not in our hand.
So radius increase
Right?
कर
So we
देती
cannot
उसको.
control. Yeah, that's what the point. Because once your fluid is fixed, your tube is fixed, your theta is fixed, your surface tension is fixed, these are not in your hand. So only thing in your hand from this formula is just the R only. You can minimize more and more R, and just to calculate the R where this delta is just like very 0.01 mm or something. So it means you will get just flat. Fine. Wherever you have the, I mean, the options there where you want to do the measurement, you have the options. You can always use a high value of theta. So in case of the manometer fluid, manometer may also you have U2, you fill a fluid there. So you are being filled most of the time the mercury. It's two reasons, because you want to measure the exact pressure. So you want it flat first thing. First thing is the meniscus need to be flat. So that can be done from here by changing this theta. So in that case, the theta value is very, very high. But the mercury is also too much high, so it will become depressed. Your H will become minus. Cos theta, if it is more than 90, your theta value, cos theta value would become minus and minus. Yes or no? So again, you would be in problem. So you need somewhere close to zero. So most of the time, your theta is not in your hand. Only thing in your R. Fine? So this is how you can control the capillary rise and fall both. This formula is valid for both the cases. Now this is, again, you have the same picture here, the capillary tube delta H. So wherever your contact angle is less than the 90. So can you see the contact angle in the previous case? This is the case of water here. So your tangent need to be drawn only inside the liquid, not outside one. Because some person can say, I can draw the tangent here and this is the contact angle. No, because you are not in fluid here. Fluid is outside here, right? So you have to draw that this is your contacting surface and this is your the interface. So you have to draw the tangent within the fluid only. So this is your contact angle here. So this contact angle here less than the 90. It means this particular fluid would rise up and it will wet the surface. So based on contact angle of the fluid, you can tell what type of the fluid is, what would be the capillary rise or fall. If contact angle is less than the 90, it will wet the surface also and it will rise, have capillary rise, just like delta H. See, in this case of the mercury case here, this is the surface and tangent here will go to this side here. So this is your contact angle, which is more than the 90 degree here. In this case, you will have capillary depression or capillary fall and it will not wet the surface. Fine. So your wetting fluid should have the contact angle less than the 90. Non-wetting fluid should have contact angle more than the 90. What do the surface, this soap soap does in water? Why do we put the soap for cleaning of the means your clothes? Any idea?
Sir, it reduces surface tension of the water.
Yeah, that's what in the back one also here. So in case of this one in back slide here, so this you want to control this particular edge also here. You want to decrease the surface tension more and more. So what will happen here? Surface tension decrease kar diya, so your edge would become
decrease
low, right? लोइज हो जाएगा, यस और नो?
यस सर।
सो हाउ डज इट बेनिफिट? सो एच इज लो, आर इज फिक्स्ड, बिकॉज द फैब्रिक का जो मेश साइज है, द फैब्रिक हैव द मेश साइज ना, यू हैव द फाइन फाइबर्स, सो दैट आर इज फिक्स्ड।
सर देन वाटर कैन इजीली गेट इनटू द पोर्स ऑफ द फाइबर।
But how? You see from this formula.
Sir,
what about the contact angle? it has decreased also. Not only sigma, contact angle has also decreased by this putting the soap. So decrease means this, as you will become cos value 0 and 0, your value will become more and more. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. But so cos, listen to yes. me. So by putting your soap bubble, your contact angle has been the decrease. Surface tension has been also the decrease. Total magnitude of two would actually increase. So finally, you will have this capillary jar rise. How would it help? That is my question here. So you have just like a, I will show you here. So this is your, can you see here? This one is your fiber mesh. यहाँ पे जो आपका कपड़ा होता है cloth. So each mesh is the something like that. Now what you want? This have some thickness, right? Your fiber have the some thickness. Yes or no? Cloth.
Sir.
Cloth yes. have the some thickness, right?
Yes, sir.
Now for that thickness, you want your soap. Your जो आपने सोप डाला है क्लॉथ में, यू वॉन्ट दैट सोप शुड गो ऑटोमेटिकली इन टू पोर एंड कम आउट फ्रॉम द पोर, दैट्स व्हाई द क्लीनिंग इज डन. सो यू पुट द सोप, डिक्रीज द सरफेस टेंशन एट द सेम टाइम द थीटा, सो फाइनली योर एच हैज इंक्रीज एक्चुअली. सो एच हैज इंक्रीज मीन्स इन द सच ए वे इट इज द मोर देन द योर थिकनेस ऑफ द एंटायर फाइबर. So that your soap bubble, soap can go up and penetrate into the entire fiber. Therefore, you will get automatically cleaning. You don't need any shaking by hand. Okay? You got the point?
Yes, sir.
So you have the maximize the edge at that particular point. Just to soap automatically pass into the pore and take out the all mud and dust and clean your cloth without any sort of the mechanical agitation from the outside, because mechanical agitation of the cloth distort your fiber, your quality of fiber. Therefore, what dry cleaning people do, they just hold the cloth something like that and pass the a cleaning fluid where it can pass easily without any disturbance from the outside. Therefore, your cloth shines and remain very good for a longer period of time as compared to the cleaning by hand, right? Yes or no? This is the only reason. So we can close today here, and in the next class we will do the something here, right?
Yes, sir.